I'm Jesse. Today, for the tip of the day, I want to show you how to shut down your IP500 V2 control unit. Many people don't know that you have to shut it down before you remove the power. And the reason for that is the SD card that the control unit uses. The system is constantly reading and writing information to that SD card, so if you remove power before you shut the system down, then you can damage the data on the card, so you can get corrupt data on the card. So you want to shut it down before you pull the plug. Now there's two ways to do that. I'll show you both of those ways here today. You can do it from the software if you're connected either directly to the control unit from your computer or through a network, on a company network. Or you can do it right from the control unit. So first I'll show you the software. We'll take a look on the computer here. This is the manager software. We're going to click on File, Advanced, and then System Shutdown. A window will open up. It will show your control unit here in a few seconds. As you can see in the bottom left corner, I have 255.255.255.255. That's a broadcast address that tells the system to search. It tells the software to search for my system, basically. So here we see my system, and we're going to click on the checkbox next to it, and then click on OK. It'll ask for the username and password. The default username is administrator, and the default password will vary depending on the version that you're using. In release 7, it would be administrator with a capital A, the same as the username. Or if you're using basic mode, it would be password, all lowercase password. Also, in Release 8, they've changed the default password to password on both versions. And I have the choice here. The default choice is timed, and you'll see that it says 10 minutes in the window here. So if I leave it like this, it will shut the system down for 10 minutes, and then it will start back up on its own. I can change this time to a different amount of time, or I can switch it to indefinite, which will shut the system down and it will not start back up. So I'm going to choose indefinite and click OK. And then it lets me know that I have to wait for it to shut down, basically. And then click Yes to proceed. And this basically just reminds you that you have to wait for the lights on the front of the unit to turn red and orange. They'll be blinking red and orange on the front of the unit when it's done shutting down. Also, on the back of the unit, if you look at the back of the unit, you'll notice that, I'm gonna turn it this way here. The CPU light on the back of the unit will start to flash, and the system SD card light will eventually turn off.